We've heard a lot about drones of the future being used to deliver anything from pizzas to packages. But there are some innovators around the world who have a higher calling to deploy drones to save lives. Here's Albert Lawrence to explain.
Emergency medical care is a vital need for all of us. But in developing countries and even in rural areas of the United States, access to medical supplies can be limited due to rugged terrain, poor road infrastructure, or simply long distances to ER facilities. But with the use of modern technology and innovative thinking, those once formidable obstacles may no longer impede the chances to save a life. I hopped a flight to Sacramento, California to meet Keller Renato, the young CEO of a company called Zipline, which takes to the skies with blood that flies.
Zipline makes instant deliveries of medicine to hospitals and health centers, and we do that using autonomous aircraft that are fully electric and weigh about 40 pounds.
How does that work?
The idea is really simple. Any doctor or nurse at one of the health centers or hospitals that we serve can send Zipline a text message saying that they need an emergency medical product. When we get that, we immediately take that product out of our inventory, put it in one of the aircraft, and then the aircraft can fly autonomously out to the hospital in an average of 15 or 30 minutes.
The first country in the world to sign up was the African nation of Rwanda.
What are the materials that are most commonly delivered using Zipline?
So we deliver red blood cells, plasma, and platelets. We're currently delivering about 33% of the national blood supply of Rwanda. We've taken Rwanda from an average blood waste rate of about 7% to practically 0%. They're the first country in the world to achieve that.
The autonomous aircraft Zipline uses are custom-made drones.
The aircraft, the flight computer, all of the software, the flight control algorithms that fly the airplane. We've designed all this technology from scratch so that it can operate reliably day in and day out and do hundreds of deliveries in a way that people can rely on with their lives.
The drones are launched using a catapult system, and prepping one for a mission doesn't take a lot of time.
When we get an order, we immediately have to take a wing and a battery. Then we end up loading it into one of these fuselages over here. And at the same time, we'll load a package into the airplane so that we have everything that we need to deliver. And that fits right in here if you want to see.
Every package is scanned with a barcode, which gives the drone the exact GPS location for delivery. And after the drop, the drone flies back to its base. But it doesn't land.
The way that we recover the plane, it's weird, but it works. And the way we do that is using an arresting cable that tracks the plane and will then basically grab a 1 centimeter target on the very back of the airplane.
This method of launching and snatching multiple drones at a time helps Zipline make up to 500 life-saving deliveries per day. Keller and I drove a few miles out into the California countryside so he could show me how an actual delivery works.
Basically, as long as you have a cell phone, you can send a text message and get any product you need in 15 to 30 minutes.
Zipline is looking to expand its service to 10 to 20 countries in the near future, including the U.S.
This is the future of delivery.
Right? That was very fun.